and I hope that's been useful. So I'm just going to have a quick look at Hatchet or Quarry. There was a request for that, just real quick before we go. I'm going to do that as a free roam, just to make life a bit easier. Cheers, train driver Louis. Right. Just updating Twitch and promos and right. So we've started a free roam. So this is the quarry area. There's the O4 in the industrial livery, which I rather like. A rather interesting name. And over here, you have to kind of go and see it, is the quarry. Sort of a bit away from the railway. So let's go back to the railway. That up. So let's take this train, it's as good as any, and make sure we've got a clear route out. Which we now do. Go on then, hot dog. What does LOL stand for? Laugh out loud. Excellent. Right. Yes, I decided to just do this Hatchet Hill Quarry because it's been requested two or three times now. So I thought I'd give a quick free roam demo of it. If you like sort of freight shunting type things, it's quite good. Now I didn't want to fill the last two cars dark. So over here, if we let my train go off, is the other shunter in BR Blue livery. The lights on top do look a bit like the ones on the top of a Dalek, don't they? Yes, you can open the doors. Turn on some headlights. Alright then, we'll turn on headlights. Just for you, Dark, alright? Just for you. Cheers, hot dog. Thanks for joining us this evening. A handbrake there. Slide the windows open, can you? Oh, there you go. So this is a fictional route. Going from the quarry to this mainline station over here. There's the main line extending for a little while. Where have we got to? We're currently here. We've got Hatchet Hill Station just coming up here. Points are all set for us to go straight through. However, just to be difficult, I'm going to route it through the other line, through the loop. You know, I honestly can't remember, Daily, if it's either an 03 or an 04. I think it's an 04. How fast can you get out of this? Not very. We're doing a whopping 15 at the moment. It's even got wipers. So where are we at? We're just coming up on Hatchet Hill Station, just about halfway along the line. It's not particularly long, takes a little while at the 15 miles per hour though. Is it? Let's go and have a look. Yeah, it reckons it can get to 28. Certainly doesn't seem to want to do 28. Got the distance signal for the station. So a speed limit of 15 coming up, so we just need to take special notice of that speed limit. No, we don't. I look like I'm in the woods. Oh. So I'll tell you what we'll do, just to keep this free roam interesting. Because that's what we need. We need interesting free roams. Oh, I love that boarded up old station. That's a nice touch. Alright, let's cut the... Ah! That's the wrong button. Right. Put a bit of brakes on. Change that point. And we'll go in and get those wagons. I was going to put more on, actually. Sure, I recall someone saying there is something wrong with the physics of this load, but it means it doesn't actually reach its full potential. Bit of a bang. Hey there, Manulo. Welcome back to Lodo Ben. Welcome to the channel, guys. So, we are now leaving there, and our next port of call is the terminus over here. Yeah, I was thinking maybe the 37 would have been a better choice, but this is the loco that comes with the pack, so it doesn't hurt to show the loco off. It's a bit different. And I like shunters, even though this one's slow. Thank you. So we're just driving the Hatchet Hill Quarry line. It's just a free roam scenario. We're not doing anything too taxing. Picked up our wagons, and we're on our way to the main station at the other end of the branch line. Hello, we're going 20 miles an hour. We must be going downhill. Let's set up that famous scene that we all know from a famous particular show, except it's with a diesel, not a steam engine. And a bunch of wagons instead of two coaches. I wouldn't bank on it, Dave. We're about to go up a hill, so I think one of the hamsters is probably going to need to step out for a break. Welcome back, Lee Watcher Streams. Dark is getting excited at the mention of hamsters. Well, it's got two or three, but what they do is they take it in shifts, Dark. There's never more than one running at a time. And then there's mandatory lunch break, of course, where none of them get to run for a while. Hey, Manulo. No, I'm not, actually. It's a green screen, so I can turn it on and off. Like so. Ooh, look at me. I'm flying in the fields. That's just weird. Or I can change it for a different cab. That's just the power of modern technology. How cool is that? What have we got going on around here? So we've got a bit of a halt there. Small village. Judging by the viewer numbers, this is not the most popular scenario that I've ever run. But that's fine. Different strokes, as they say. Where have we got to here? There we are, so we've got to make it all the way around the left, and then we're nearly there. They're actually just screenshots from the game, Manulo. So this is a screenshot of the Class 319 cab from the game. If you look carefully down here, you can see the game world from where I took the screenshot. But as you say, they do work rather well. I was quite pleased how well they came out. Come on. I'm going to fire these hamsters and get new ones. That's a rather nice windmill in the distance there.
Yeah.
As I say to my kids, Dave, yes, we're just looking for somewhere to park. What I need to do is have a horrendous accident, and then that'll make sure this video becomes the number one on the YouTube channel. Strangely enough, for the number of people that logged off the Twitch for the tutorial, the freight and passenger tutorials are the number one and number two scenarios by a very, very long way on YouTube. I think it's something like 10 times more minutes watched of the tutorials. Than of every other video, or all the other videos. So maybe the tutorials are better suited for the YouTube audience, and the Twitch audience wants to see gameplay. Which is quite reasonable. Yeah, my kids love it when I say, yeah, we're just looking for somewhere to park, and we're flying down the motorway. Very good, Duck. Now we've finished the left-hand turn, we should be nearly there. Yeah, we're going to go up this bit, turn right again, and then we're nearly there. Now, where is the blue line going to take us? It will go in this siding, I think. Yep, go to reception siding there, that'll do. Oh, Dave, I mean the one with the A4 on London to Brighton that I didn't do very well on. Very good, Dave. You got it right, Steve. We need a nice EMD. Stick an SD70 on the front. Nearly there. No, I think a nice J94. Or an FEF. There you go, an FEF, that's what we need. I think the FEF 3 will work on this line. Seems legitimate. So we've got the main line over there, and this is us coming round into the corner into the station area. Oh, we're struggling to get up this hill. Wow, this is a steep hill. 1 in 48. Dobbsy, this is a fictional route, so I'm not entirely sure where it's intended to be in the world. So we need to be in second gear to get this thing up the hill. There's the top of the hill there, nice angular joint. What other engines would I recommend? Probably, I'd basically say just about anything shuntery, anything small tank engine steam-wise. I mean, it's fictional, so you can kind of get away with what do you want to run. I mean, in theory, you could probably get away with something American on it, like a SW1 or something like that. But, I mean, if you're sticking to British stuff, then, yeah, any of the little shunters, I'd probably go... I think the 37 feels a bit big for it. I'd probably go for something a bit smaller. A high mech would probably be about the right size. Or a big boy. Yes, Dark. A big boy is another option, indeed. Because that would make it round the corners. Hey there, Eamon Trains. Thanks for joining us. We're just struggling to get this train up this 1 in 48 gradient. I think this would be really quite pleasant with a Great Western 56XX or a Prairie. That'd be quite pleasant. I mean, there is the passenger station, so you could run trains down to the passenger station, run round them through the loop, and then bring them back up here again. So there is a little bit of passenger activity you can do, although obviously it's centred around the quarry down the end. And prairies, yeah, absolutely. They're not really small for the UK, Eamon. These are just our wagons generally tend to be a little bit on the small side. They're I can't remember what they're called. No, I can't remember what these particular wagons are called. They've got a sea dog or sea lion or something like that type name on them. 14, that's an excellent idea, Dark. 14 would be ideal for it. A 20 is possibly a bit overkill, but maybe. A Clayton's almost certainly. A 17 is probably too big. So we've got a red signal coming in here. Hey, now we've been approved. I'm on the approved list. Yes, I know you're. I'm going to make the assumption that you're American there, E-Man trains. You've got. Your freight trains are far more impressive. Both in terms of numbers of wagons and size and capacity of wagons. Although we're getting there. I mean, these are quite old wagons. These are certainly not new ones. Dave, no, I didn't see that. I'll have to go and look at Twitter when I've finished here. Catfish, that's the one I was looking for, Dark. Catfish. Take the junction round here. Yes, Doug. Class 03, Class 02, Class 1. All of those would fit nicely. Right. That was Hatch Hill Quarry. And now I really am going to call it a night, I think. Thanks for joining me. And I hope the tutorial was useful, even though the scenario at the end of the day didn't actually work quite the way that it was supposed to. The techniques certainly are valid. And I shall be back tomorrow. With just scenarios, not tutorials, and we've got a couple down to look at tomorrow. So, yes, I shall see you tomorrow. Thanks for joining tonight, and I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have. Goodbye.